Amen.
Amen. Amen. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
We're so glad that you took the time to join us this morning for another service here at Wise Choice Ministries.
Amen.
We are here and we just bless the Lord and we love the Lord so much because He has been so faithful and so good. So that we're just glad to be here. So we have another opportunity to give Him praise and thanks for what He has done. He's so good. So we thank you for joining us in the absence of our pastor, Dr. Shana Wise, and Deacon Ryan Wise. They are pastor-elect Ryan Wise. We are here. We will carry on. And we thank you for them. We pray for their safe travels as they will be returning back home tomorrow. So we pray for their safe travels, and they will be with us next Sunday. But in their absence, we will continue. We bless God for this opportunity to be here this morning.
Amen.
So we're going to open up in prayer with the scripture. So Heavenly Father, we just come once again with a humble heart, thanking you for all of your goodness. You've been so good. You're so gracious. You're so sovereign. And we just praise your holy name. We thank you for all that you have done and all that you will do in the future. We just ask that you be a part of this service today. Let us honor you with our words, with our songs, with our praise. We do everything so that you will get the glory. And we thank you in advance. And we just thank you for today, a blessed day. It is a blessed day. And we will rejoice and be glad in it. So Heavenly Father, have your way in this service. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Amen. And our scriptures today come from Matthew's, the 5th chapter. We've been talking about the love of God. All this month has been our theme scripture. And our Sunday school lesson had followed up on that, talked about the love of God and how He wants us to behave in our spiritual walk as well as our moral walk. So Matthew 5:17 says, "Think not that I have come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle shall not in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled." And He goes on from there to tell us about the things that we are to do, all the commandments that we are to keep. And He said, "But I say to you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you." Amen.
Amen.
So we know that those, it is no way that we can keep those commandments of behavior or any of the commandments without the help of God. We just have to let God know we need you every day and every hour, because if we're going to, if we already have the righteousness of Jesus, and if we're going to live the way He wants us to live, we have to depend on Him and the Holy Spirit to lead, guide, and direct us in our walk. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So we're going to go with our announcements today, right here at Wise Choice. Our theme for this month is the love of God. And our scripture verse is 1 John 4:7-8. "Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love." So our challenge for this, that's our theme scripture for the month. Our Bible study on Tuesdays, we will be referencing that scripture, and we know that God loves us. And if you haven't had a chance, please join us on Tuesday for our Bible study.
Amen.
And it is just amazing, and it is just awesome how much God does love it. And when you get that in your soul and in your spirit, there's nothing that you can't do, because you won't walk around feeling bad because no one likes you.
Amen.
And no, someone did you wrong. If you know the love of God, He will give you perfect peace. So join us on Tuesday for our Bible study, as we continue to study the love of God. And of course, stay connected to Rise Choice Ministries. Subscribe to our Facebook pages and our Instagrams and all the social medias. By the way, if you're following us on Facebook, if you're watching us on Facebook this morning, make sure you check in and tell some of your friends to join us. They won't be disappointed.
Amen.
You are invited. We had our first bingo meeting at our new location at the library on Don Avenue, and it was well received. We thank all of you who came in. We thank all of you who stopped by to come and visit us, and we invite and all of you who are in the city, if you're not busy on Tuesday mornings at 11 o'clock, you're welcome to come join us at the Highlands Library on Don Avenue for our non-gambling bingo day. We do that every Tuesday from 11 to about 1 o'clock. So please join us. And of course, we are still in the process. We are here at Airport Road now, but we're certainly in the process of looking for a new building, and we will keep you updated on that. And now it's your turn to participate through your giving. We thank you in advance for all that you have given and you continue to give in support of Rise Choice Ministries. Your gifts are being sold on good ground. This is a ministry that truly cares about people in the community. And so whatever you give, we thank you for that and know that God is pleased with your giving. There's many, we do have Cash App and Givelify, so you're able to do that on any one of those outlets, and we thank you for that.
Amen.
And today you are in for a special treat following our praise and worship by Brother Travis. Our very own Elder Sophia Jeffrey has a word for you, and she is going to... By the help of the Holy Spirit, she is going to give us an interpretation of the love of God this morning. And so we thank you. We're looking forward to that. But for right now, we're going to bring up our very own Brother Travis, and he's going to lead us in praise and worship.
Amen.
Thank you. Amen. Amen. Brother Travis.
Amen.
How many glad to be in the house of the Lord today? Oh, let's give him praise. He deserved it. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Come on in, take a seat. Inhabit a praise, God of Zion, Judah's Lion. We acknowledge your presence, O Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Come on in, take a seat. Inhabit a praise, God of Zion, Judah's Lion. We acknowledge your presence, O Lord. God of mercy, show your glory as we enter this place. Show us your face, God of peace, give us peace. We acknowledge your presence, O Lord. God, show us as we enter this place. Show us your face, God of peace, give us peace. We acknowledge your presence, O Lord. Come on in, Jesus, take a seat, inhabit a praise. God of Zion, Judah's Lion. Oh, God of mercy, God, show us as we enter this place. Show us your face, God of peace. Oh, give us peace. We acknowledge your presence, oh Lord. Oh, 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 come on in. We acknowledge. Oh, 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 come on and lift your worship. Come on in. We acknowledge. Oh, 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 come on in. Take a seat. Come on in. Come on, invite him in. We need ya. Come on in. I want you to take a seat, oh God. Have your way. Come on in. Oh, take a seat, oh God. We need ya. Come on in. It's your time. Your time to be blessed. And we honor you. We lift you on high. Oh, yeah. Somebody invite him in the house. Come on in. Come on in. Take a seat. Come on in. Take a seat. All right. Oh, whoa. And we lift them on high. We acknowledge your presence, oh Lord. Come on in. Invite the Holy Spirit. Come on in. Oh, 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 oh. Come on in, invite the Holy Spirit. We acknowledge. Oh, 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 come on, I need to hear you out there. Come on in. Let's make the devil out of a liar. Acknowledge his presence. Oh, 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 oh. Put your hands together. Let's give God Hallelujah. Some glory. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Ooh, 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 ooh. I worship you, Lord. Jehovah Jireh. Glory, hallelujah. You're my Prince of Peace. Yes, you are. And I worship you. Just because. Just because. Because. Hallelujah. Somebody lift your worship.
I give you glory, yeah.
Because of who you are, you praise, hey, just because. Lift my voice and say, worship you, Lord, worship you. Worship him across the building. Hallelujah. He deserved the praise. You see, you're Jehovah, who my provider. Glory, hallelujah. Jehovah Nisi. Begin to get in that secret place. You, Lord, you reign. You reign victory. Jehovah Shalom. Prince of Peace, and yes, you are. Worship, yes, and we worship, yes. Just because, Jehovah, Jehovah, Jehovah Jireh, my provider, who you made a way where there seemed to be no way. Jehovah Nisi, you Lord, you reign. You're my Prince of Peace, and yes, you are. Worship, yes, and we worship, yes. I was born to worship. I love to worship. Ooh, it's an honor, Jesus. It's an honor. You are. Because of who you are.
Hallelujah.
Lord, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you worship, thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Amen, amen. Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen.
My Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
hallelujah.
You.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We worship you.
Yes, God.
For who you are. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
I was glad when they said unto me that I was going to the house of the Lord.
Yes.
Yes, Lord. I'm glad to be in the number.
Yes.
Glory to
that's
your
right,
name
man.
And your righteous name. God, you are just so good. So good. Let me open us up with prayer on the day. Father God, we just come this morning, Father God, just to say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you, Father God, for life, health, and strength, and because of who you are.
Yes.
God, you are so gracious and kind. And you are loving, faithful, Father. And for this, God, we say thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Father God, we invoke your presence into this worship service
yes,
today.
God.
Father God, I invite you into this message today. God, I need you today. Father God, speak to me, Lord, and through me. Move in a mighty way, God. Lord, your word is more powerful than anything, God. And we just say thank you for your word. God, we just come, Lord, we get, ask, Lord, that you give us a receiving spirit, that you open up your heart, open up our hearts and our minds to receive from you on today. Father God, have your way.
Have your way.
Spirit of the living God, fall fresh upon me today, Father God. I said, Spirit of the living God, fall
living
fresh
God. Yes,
upon
God.
Me today, Lord.
Yes.
Yes, Lord. I decrease, Lord, so that you may increase in me, Father,
yes,
God,
Father,
and fill me up with your power and your Holy Spirit. Yes. And God, I ask, Lord, that you anoint these words afresh, Lord, that you could turn right now. It is just information, Father God, but if you breathe on them, you'll turn into revelation. And Father God, anoint these lips of clay, Lord, so that no enemy, nothing can hinder or come be hindered by any outside force, Lord. And Lord, that we can give you all the praise and honor and glory, Lord. And we just thank you, Father. We acknowledge your presence. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, I thank you.
Amen.
God, we worship you for who you are. That's such a fitting song because you are just so good.
Yes.
And you are worthy to be praised. You're worthy for us to worship you.
Yes.
Today, I'd like to give thanks and honor to God, who is Jesus Christ, who is the head of our life.
Yes.
And I'd like to send greetings and traveling grace and mercy to our pastor and pastors while they are in their absence. I believe they're traveling today, I think, or will be traveling tomorrow. So they are enjoying themselves, and we pray for them to continue to be blessed, and that they are doing well, and that God has them covered, and he has us covered in
Amen.
Their absence. So we thank you for that, Father God. So today I'm going to be coming from the book of Romans, and if you could all stand for the reading of the word. We're coming from the book of Romans, chapter 5, the book of Romans, and we go on chapter 5. And starting from that fifth verse, and I'm reading from the Passion Translation because I found out that when you read different translations of the word, it gives you more of an insight for God to give you revelation.
Amen.
So the King James Version is a good version, and I love it too, but this one is fitting for me. So I'm going to read from in the book of Romans chapter 5, and we start at that fifth verse, and the word of God says, and this hope is not a disappointing fantasy, because we can now experience the endless love of God cascading in our hearts through the Holy Spirit who lives in us.
Yes.
Verse 6, for when the time was right, the anointed one came and died to demonstrate his love for sinners,
yes,
who were entirely helpless, weak, and powerless to save themselves.
Amen.
Now, would anyone dare to die for the sake of a wicked person? We can all understand if someone was willing to die for a truly noble person. But Christ, thank God for the but.
Mm-hmm.
But Christ proved God's passionate love for us,
mm-hmm,
by dying in our place while we were still lost and ungodly.
My Lord.
And there is still much more to say of his unfailing love for us.
Yeah.
For through the blood of Jesus, we have heard the powerful declaration, you are now righteous in my sight.
My Lord.
And because of the sacrifice of Jesus, you will never experience the wrath of God. Verse 10. Mm. So if while we were still enemies, God fully reconciled us to himself through the death of his son, then something greater than friendship is ours. Now that we are at peace with God, and because we share in his resurrection life, how much more will we be rescued from sin's dominion? And even more than that, we overflow that with triumphant joy in our new relationship of the living reconciled to God.
Amen. Amen.
All because of Jesus Christ. Thus ends the reading of the word.
Amen.
You may claim your seat.
Amen.
If I had to give a title to this message, I would say the powerful love of God.
Mm.
The powerful love of God.
Amen.
How many of you know, first of all, this morning in Sunday school, we talked about the little minute things, the little little intricate things that was in the word, and how not a jot, a tittle, or anything you should change the word of God. Just that little.
Yeah.
He was saying, God was saying, be careful
not to change
anything. Keep it simple, that little thing. But how many of you know that sometimes bigger is better? Bigger is better. The more we force, the more force behind an object, the more power it will bring. Let me say that again. The more force behind an object, the more power it will bring.
Right.
See, there's a lot of things. There are a lot of powerful things in this world that exists. Dictionary.com defines powerful as having or being exerting power over force over something. It's producing the great physical effect as a machine or to blow. It can be described as potent and having a great effectiveness and having great power, authority, influence, and mighty. All that's what powerful means and stands for. So let me share with you a few things that are powerful in the world that we can see. A tornado is powerful.
Right.
A hurricane is powerful.
Right.
A volcano eruption is powerful.
Right.
Stainless steel is powerful because nothing can break through.
Yeah.
A hydrogen bomb is powerful. A nuclear reactor is powerful.
Yeah.
The world's strongest earthquake was a 9.5 in the magnitude scale. And this happened back in 1960. It was so powerful that four different countries were affected and damaged by that hurricane, by that earthquake. So that tells you the magnitude of the power. According to Google, astronomers believe that gamma rays burst is the most powerful thing in the universe.
Mm.
But I beg to differ.
Amen.
I beg to differ because I believe the most powerful thing in the world is the love of God. He got to be the most powerful thing if he created the universe.
Yes, yes.
He got to be the most powerful thing because he is God.
Yes, yes.
See, here we have the Apostle Paul. See, Paul is showing us in these scriptures how powerful the love of God is. See, when the love of God is unmistakable, when you experience his love. You can't mistake it for anything. At least you shouldn't.
Right.
Because when somebody comes around and bless you with something good, thank them for it, but thank God first because he put it on their heart to do it.
Amen.
That's what love looks like.
Yeah.
See, God is showing us in these scriptures that his love is more powerful than anything.
Mm.
And all we need to do is allow his love to penetrate our heart and work through us. So the first thing I saw about the God's powerful love is that it never disappoints. God's the powerful love of God never disappoints. Verse 5 says, this is hope. This hope is not a disappointing fantasy. Because we can now experience endless love, the endless love of God, cascading into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who lives in us.
Mm-hmm.
To me, that means that God's love was put in our heart Which means there's no reason why other people shouldn't be able to see the love of God in
us. Amen. Amen.
Now, the power of God's love can break walls and boundaries that hate has set up.
That's right.
It can penetrate through anything if we allow it to.
Yes.
See, God loves us first so that we can allow, he allows us to love him. But he loves us first. When we didn't deserve it, he loved us anyway.
Yes.
So the power, through the power of the Holy Spirit, we get into God's presence. John 14 and 21 and the NIRV, which is the New International Reader's Version, says it like this. John 14 and 21. Jesus answered and said, Jesus answered and said, if a person really loves me, he will keep my word, obeying my teaching, and my Father will love him, and we will continue to him. We will come to him and make our home, our abode, special dwelling place in him. See, we're in his presence because he's in us. See, when we need a prayer to get through, we really don't have to go nowhere. We just need to get on our knees. Or if we can't get out on our knees, just sit still, bow our head, and look on the inside of us and send up a prayer. Because his presence is dwelling on the inside of us. His love causes us, it should cause us to obey him. The love of God constraining us, it pulls us, it compels us. That's how powerful it is. To allow us to do right. Now, see, his love can't make us do right, but it can compel us and cause us to want to do right if we choose to allow it to manifest in our heart and mind.
That's right.
That's how powerful it is. 2 Timothy 1 and 12 says, for this reason, I also suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed because it doesn't disappoint. I am not ashamed, for I know whom I believed and am persuaded that he is able to keep what is committed to him unto that day. When we commit ourselves to Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, he will keep us. So we don't have to be disappointed and worried if we're going to lose our salvation because we can't lose. He just said he committed to us. Whatever we commit to him, he's going to keep us. He will not disappoint. That's how strong and powerful his love is, that he can keep us to eternity. Now, you know that's love.
My Lord.
Now, some people might say, well, I prayed and God didn't answer my prayer and I was disappointed. Well, let me get you a newsflash. If you prayed and it wasn't according to the will of God, weren't praying. Asking for God
Amen.
For the right thing.
Amen.
See, that's why it's so important to get in the Word and read the Word so you can find out what the Word says so you can get in His will by the Word because His will is His Word.
All right now.
And when we pray in the Word of God about our situation, it's not going to disappoint. Now, I done been disappointed plenty of times by putting my hope in people.
That's right.
But when I put my hope and trust in him,
that's it.
Never disappoints.
Never.
Never makes me ashamed. When I step out on faith and say, Lord, I know I don't see it, but I'm going to do what you tell me to do by faith, and it's going to happen. Because he got the answer. That's how strong and powerful his love is. But see, in order for us to get in the power of his love, it takes some private time in our devotion. It takes some private time in our prayer life, in our praise and worship. See, the love of God was already in us, but we have to spend time with him to bring it out of us. So next, I'd like to show the power that I saw that when we were powerless, but the power of God overlooked that and gave us the power that we need. When we were powerless, he was powerful. Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Verse 6 and 7 tells us, see, God's power can overlook anything in our life when it needs it. God is so full of love for us that he overlooked our faults and saw our needs.
Amen.
Now, see, that's why I thank God that there's some human beings who is not God. They got God in them, but they ain't God.
That's right.
Because if they were God, some of us would be all messed up because they are fickle. Human beings are fickle.
That's right.
They praise you one day, and 5 minutes later, you did something they don't like. They done throw you under the bus.
That's right.
They throw you under the bus, kick you to the curb, and throw you out like you were trash.
Right.
But the powerful love of God, he ain't gonna do you like that. He gonna overlook our faults and see our needs, even though you don't deserve it. Woo! The powerful God, love of God will give you mercy and grace. Verse 6 and 7 says, for when the time was right, have mercy, Jesus, the anointed one came and died to demonstrate, that word right there, demonstrate his love for sinners who were entirely helpless, weak, and powerless to save themselves.
Right.
Lord, have mercy,
my
Jesus.
Lord.
That to me broke, busted, and disgusted right there. That's what all them three words, that right? That's what that means.
Yeah.
We've been there. He says, so was such and some of you, that's what Paul said. So let's not act like we ain't never been there, because we was. Now, would anyone dare to die for the sake of a wicked person? We can all understand if someone was willing to die for a truly noble person. Now, you know that the power of God's love got to be strong if it's willing to die for a wicked person.
That's right.
Because we all know it takes the act of Congress or act of God to move for us sometime to bless a wicked person. Let alone, well, a good person, let alone somebody who we don't care too much about.
Right.
But the love of God,
that's right,
is more powerful than that. See, when we surrender to God and to his will, we can experience his overflowing of his love.
Right.
That's how powerful it is. Psalm 69, 2 and 3 says, I sink deep in the deep mire, where there is no foothold. I have come into deep waters where the floods overwhelm me. And I am weary with my crying. My throat is parched. My eyes fail with waiting, hopefully and patiently for my God. He said, he's in the miry clay. He done got himself hemmed up in a situation. He broke, busted, and disgusted, and he all out there, he out there in the deep of quicksand. He said, but my eyes fail with waiting, hopefully, for my God.
My God.
So no matter how bad, that's telling me, no matter how bad your situation is, look to God and he'll come and show up after you. That's how powerful the love of God is.
Powerful.
Psalms 42 and 6 also tells us, says, my spirit is very sad deep inside of me. Brokenhearted. So I will remember you here where the Jordan begins, and I will remember you here on the Hermon Mountains and the mountain Mount Mizar, which means no matter where you at. No matter how low you have fallen, no matter how bad you have done, his love will come after you. That's how powerful it is. He said, I will remember you wherever you go, no matter where it is, from the north, the south, the east, and the west. God's love will come to you because that's how powerful it is.
My Lord.
Amen.
Who wouldn't want a powerful love like that for your heavenly Father? Lord, help me, Jesus. Mm-hmm. So then I saw, yes, I saw also, next I saw, the powerful love of God is seen through his actions. You know, action speaks louder than words. Action speaks louder than words. You, if you're in a relationship with your spouse or your boyfriend, or if you was a man or girlfriend, then their true test of how much they love you is what they do for you.
Mm-hmm.
See, their mouth can say, I love you, baby. All day long. Their mouth can say, I love you, baby. But if your actions ain't following that.
My Lord. Mm, come on now.
We ain't got nothing really to talk about.
All right now.
If your actions ain't lining up with your word, we ain't got nothing to talk about. Tina Turner, bless her heart. Say, what's love got to do with it? I say everything. It has everything to do with it. Because that's how powerful God's love is.
That's right.
See, his action says everything. Verse 8 says, but Christ proved. Oh, that right there. And King James, it said demonstrated.
That's it.
Christ proved God's passionate love for us by dying in our place.
Mm.
Now, sometimes we can't even get a wonderful blessing to go pick up some chicken from the store. Because he's too busy. But right here, mm-hmm. our Heavenly Father says he died in our place because of his passionate love for us.
Mm-hmm.
He'd do anything for us.
Anything.
He said, while we were still lost and ungodly.
Yes.
While we were still lost and ungodly, you ain't got to be perfect because he still loves you.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't got to be holier than thou, as they say, Bible thumpers, but he still loves you. And then verse 9 says, and there is still much more to say of his unfailing love for us. Mm. I mean, I ain't got enough time to talk to you about it. That's how much he loves us.
Yeah.
For through the blood of Jesus, we have heard the powerful declaration, you are now righteous in my sight. Just think that. Just think about that. In the previous verse, it says, for he died for the lost and the ungodly.
That's right.
But then in the very next verse it says, and there is still much more to say of his unfailing love. And then he calls us and tells us a declaration. You are now righteous in my sight. Now that's powerful. That's some powerful love. Who can change you from dirty, broke down, and disgusted to righteous in him? That's because
right.
We the righteousness of God. It's not about what we do.
That's right.
It's about what we believe.
That's it.
Now see, because what we believe gonna help in our receive the love of God in us, so his power can help us to act right and walk right and talk right.
That's it.
You just can't do anything any kind of way and think God gonna be pleased with that. He gonna give you grace enough to change. Because that's what he'd want to do, because you're supposed to be made in his image.
That's right.
It says, and in the rest of this verse 9, it says, and because of the sacrifice of Jesus, you will never experience the wrath of God. Lord, have mercy.
My Lord.
Thank you, God, for that grace and mercy right there. That's what that means. You will never, if you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you will receive, you will never experience the love of God, the wrath of God. You will never receive the wrath of God, but you will receive the power of God.
Right.
That powerful love of God. See, God demonstrated his love through Jesus Christ by dying on the cross. That's love, people. That's what love in action right there. John 10 and 11 tells us that I am the good shepherd. And the good shepherd gives his life for his sheep.
Mm.
The good shepherd. That's why he's good, because he loves us.
Yes, he does.
He's good because he loves us. So he demonstrated that by giving his life For us, that's what love looks like. Love is not just about talking. It's about doing it. It's about doing what God tells us to do. That's the power of the love. And then we see the powerful, his powerful love through his grace and mercy. Lord, I don't know what we would do without his grace and mercy. As much as I try to do right, I do something wrong every day. As much as we try to do right, somebody do something wrong every single day. But the point of it is, we got to try to not keep doing the same foolishness over and over and over again and taking his grace and mercy for granted.
Amen.
Hebrews 2 and 9 tells us, said, but we are able to see Jesus, who was ranked lower than the angels for the little while, crowned with glory and honor because of his having suffered death, in order that by grace and unmerited favor of God to us sinners, he might experience death for every individual. Mm-hmm. Because of his grace and mercy, he took our place. So we won't receive the wrath of God, but he received our death of every individual who believed. He will take death from you in the spiritual realm if you just ask him and believe it. Because it's available for him.
Yes, it is.
That's how powerful the love of God is.
Yes.
See, the love of God is so powerful for grace and mercy that he sends his word. Psalms 107 and 20 say he sent his word, which is love, which is Jesus, is the word. He sent his love to heal us and deliver us from destruction.
Yes.
That's how powerful the love of God is. See, the love of God is so powerful, it can break through anything. Hebrews 4 and 12 tells us that, and I'm going to read this in the Amplified. I think this is Amplified. No, this is New King James Version. It says, it's 4 and 12, it says, For the word of God is living and powerful, powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the division of the soul and spirit and joints, and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. Now, you know that's powerful when God can separate everything just with his word. It says making it active. That's how powerful it is. It's making it active is what the Amplified says. Making it active, operative, and energizing it, and effective, sharper than any two-edged sword. Penetrating and dividing. That's how powerful the love of God, that's the word, but Jesus is the word, which means that's love, is sharper than any two-edged sword. That's how powerful the word of God is. So when you meditate on the word of God and allow your spirit and your soul and your mind to be saturated with the word, it'll break everything off.
Yes, it will. My Lord.
It'll break everything off. Anything that's hindering you, got to leave. When you meditate in the word.
Amen.
It's Acts 10 and 38. Jesus, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, who went about doing good, healing all who was oppressed of the devil. See, the love of God is good. That's why he sent Jesus. That's how powerful the word is. We just got to get in the word so the word can get in us. He said, if you abide in me and my word abide in you. That's in John 14. If you abide in me and my word abide in you, ask whatever it will and it shall be done unto you. That's how powerful the word is. Once you got to get in him so he can get it out and through you.
That's right.
The powerful word of God. That's how powerful his love is. Then next I saw the powerful love of God brings us back to him through reconciliation.
That's it.
I remember, boy, when I in the Navy, we would go on deployments and we would go out to sea. There was nothing better than knowing you was coming home. The best feeling in the world is knowing you coming home, you standing out there on the ship, we at parade rest, we dressed down in our whites, our dress blues, whichever summer, whether it was summer or winter, and you can see your family standing out there and you be thinking, yes, Lord, I am coming home. But imagine when your father, your heavenly father, brings you back home to where you are. That's how powerful the love of God is. It'll reach and grab you from wherever you at. So no matter where you at, the prodigal son couldn't stay. He couldn't stay because the love of God went out there and reached the point. Get your behind back on home. Get your behind back home where you at. Remember growing up, I used to be outside with the boys running because we used to play. But when it started getting dark, Mama, it's time. It's time to come home.
That's it.
Not in them words, but yeah. But when you hear her voice, it's time to go home. We're running home because it's time come home.
That's right.
It's time to come home. So the love of God is so powerful that it reconciles us back to Him through Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 10 and 11 says, so if while we were still enemies, He's still showing us that no matter how jacked up you are, no matter how messed up you are, you won't have to get right to come to church. You can't get right to come to church. Come to church and get He can get you right while you're up in there.
Right. That's right.
That ain't nothing but an excuse. I'm going to get myself right. You the reason why you got jacked. I mean, messed up in the first place.
That's right.
I'm going to get myself. That's how we get off in the ditch. Ourself.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 10 says, if while we were still enemies,
that's right,
God fully reconciled us to Himself through the death of His Son.
That's right.
Then something greater than friendship is ours. That's just a little minute part of it right there. If friendship, that's how the relationship starts, through friendship. But He wants a relationship with you. It says now that we are at peace with God. And because we share in His resurrection life. That's the power right there. There's power in the resurrection.
Power.
Right there. That's the love. The resurrection brings the love of God to you. That brings you up. The resurrection life. How much more will we be rescued from sin's dominion? Have mercy. Verse 11 says, and even more than that, we overflow with the triumphant joy in our new relationship, went from friendship to relationship, of living reconciled to God, all because of Jesus Christ.
All because of the powerful love of Jesus Christ.
God can save you and deliver you through the power of His love. See, the love of God saves us. Hebrews 7 and 25 tells us how the love of God saves us. It says, I love this right here. Therefore, He is able to also save us to the uttermost. To the utmost. That's the Amplified. That said the uttermost. Completely. Because I'm wanting for the Amplified because you got to see it. The King James Version said the uttermost. To the utmost.
That's right.
But I'm going to show you what the Amplified says. Completely, perfectly, finally, and for all time and eternity.
The uttermost.
It said completely, perfectly, finally, and for all time and eternity.
Amen. My Lord.
Those who come to God through Him, through Jesus, says He is always living to make petition to God and intercede with Him and intervene for us.
Lord.
He always praying for us.
Always.
He just like mothers. Mm-hmm. That's why we do it.
That's right.
Because our Heavenly Father trained us to pray for our loved ones Because Jesus is intervening on our behalf,
right,
interceding on our behalf.
Right.
That's why you wasn't in the car wreck, because Jesus turned it away.
That's right.
That powerful love of God turned it away. He put that hedge of protection around you to protect you. That's how powerful it is. And you like, man, Lord, if you got some wits about you, you say, Lord, thank you, Jesus, you just saved me.
That's right.
Other people who ain't got the knowledge of God, you're just as lucky. No, luck ain't got nothing to do with that. I am blessed by the favor and grace of God.
Right.
Don't take God credit. He did it.
Right.
When he sent Jesus to protect
me. That's right.
Jeremiah 29 and 12 through verse 14, and I'm reading this in the Common English Bible. It says the CEB version. When you call me, ooh, Jesus.
When you call me.
Oh, here it is right here. When you call me and come and pray to me, I will listen to you.
Yes.
When you search for me. Yes, search for me with your whole heart. Don't be faking it. Don't be pretending. He said, when you search for me, yes. He put emphasis on it. Search for me with your whole heart. You will find me. I will present to you. I will be present for you, declares the Lord. And I will end your captivity. I will gather you from all the nations and places where I have scattered you.
Right.
And I will bring you home after the long exiles, declare the Lord. See, the Bible says, train up a child in the way they should go. And when they are old, they will not depart from it.
Mm-hmm.
God ain't going to stop you from acting a fool when you want to act a fool.
Mm-hmm.
When you bigger and bad enough and grown enough to do whatever it is you want to do, because you ain't in your mama's house no more, God can let you do exactly what you want to do.
That's right.
But so far.
Mm-hmm.
He can let you do exactly whatever you want to do, but so far, that it won't mess up the call he got on your life.
Mm.
But when it's time, and he gets your attention by shaking that tree, because he will, that's when he says, when you call me and come and pray to me, I will listen. He always has an ear for you. The problem is, we ain't speaking to him. But he says, search me. Yes, search me with your whole heart. And you will find me. He says, seek me. Knock and it shall. He said, knock and ask and it shall be given unto you. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be open. That's why sometimes we have to pray and ask more than one time. Because he wants to see how bad you want it. Are you serious about this thing that you really want to come to me? But God is telling us here that no matter how far you go, he could bring you back to him. And that's the powerful love of God. Lord, I thank you. So in closing, have mercy, Jesus. In closing, I just want to say that the powerful God that we serve has a powerful love that's worthy of all our praise. He is a true lover of our souls, and he will never leave us nor forsake us. Let that sink in. He will never leave us nor forsake us is what he tells us in Hebrews, I think 5 or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's in Hebrews. But if he never leaves us or forsake us, that means he's always there for us because he's waiting to listen for us to call to him.
Right.
The love of God can save us. Ooh. It's so powerful to save us.
Right.
It's powerful to heal us. It's powerful to deliver us. It's powerful to sustain us. It's powerful enough to provide for us.
Yes, God.
He's Jehovah Jireh. He's our provider. Everything we need is in him. And his love,
that's right.
Because that's how powerful he is.
Amen. Amen.
And I thank God for the powerful
Amen.
Love of God.
Love of God, my Lord.
Lord. Yes, yes,
powerful
yes.
Powerful love of God, my Lord.
The powerful love of God will deliver us from every destruction, a form of destruction that the enemy sends our way. It says that, give it to me, Holy Spirit. No weapon that formed against me shall prosper.
No.
Woo!
Oh, yeah.
And every tongue that shall rise up against me in judgment, I will condemn, for this is the heritage of the servant of the Lord.
That's it. That's it.
And my righteousness is of him, saith the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Matter what the enemy comes up with you, it can't stop. It can't hurt you.
He can't.
When the enemy comes in like a flood, thank you, Holy Spirit, he'll lift up the standard against you.
Yes, he will.
Because it's not going to prosper. The standard is the Holy Spirit. The standard is the word. And my Lord, the standard is the powerful love of God.
Powerful.
If you just let him use it in your life. So God's love is free to us.
Mm-hmm.
But it costs his son everything.
That's right.
But he gave it up freely so that we could live. He died so that you and I could live.
Amen.
Because that's the powerful love of God.
Because
God loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten son, that so that whosoever shall believe in him should have everlasting life. So when we allow the love of God to transform us, to deliver us, and set us free. If you can't get a good picture, if you don't want to know what love looks like, envision Calvary cross. Envision Calvary cross, the cross of Calvary, and how they laid our Savior, our Lord and Savior, put him on that cross.
My Lord.
First they put nails in his hands and they put spikes in his feet. They stretched him wide and then they hung him high. And he hung his head and he died. But they made the fatal mistake. Jesus said, if I be lifted up from the earth, that he will draw men unto you. But then they lifted him up. And when they lifted him up, the power of God was activated. Because that was on a Friday. And when they thought all hope was lost, that was that Friday. But I thank God for the but. See, if you don't ever realize why Sunday morning is so good, you need to think about what happened 3 days later, because early Sunday morning,
my Lord,
the most powerful thing in the universe got up, the other powerful thing in the universe, which is Jesus, which is his love, and raised him up out of the dead. The power of God has the power to heal you, save you, deliver you, and set you free. That's how powerful it is. And resurrect any dead thing in your life, because
anything.
He's that powerful. So with that, all I can say, that the power of God's love is so powerful that it can transform you. It's transforming me.
That's right.
And it will transform anybody who allow the powerful love of God to enter their heart and life. So I thank God for Jesus.
Amen.
I thank God for his powerful love. And I thank God for saving me.
Amen.
And that's the end of my testimony for today.
Amen.
So today, what I've talked to you about is the powerful love of God. And it's so powerful that it can reach you right where you're seated at. His love is so powerful, can break every chain of yoke on your life. And everything that I talked about today is only available through his son, Jesus Christ. So if you don't know Jesus Christ for the pardoning of your sins,
that's right,
to put you in relationship with this most powerful God, you cannot partake in anything that I'm talking to you about. But if you make up in your mind that I need some of that powerful God in me, He's willing and able and well ready to save you to the uttermost.
That's it.
Romans, if you believe in your heart and confess after me, this will open a door and allow you to enter the relationship with Jesus Christ. Romans 10:9-10 says, if you confess your sins,
right,
He's faithful and just to forgive you of your sins and cleanse you of all unrighteousness. No,
that's 1 John 1:9.
That's 1 John 1:9.
Mm-hmm.
Romans 10:9-10 tells us that if I confess with my heart,
that's right,
my mouth, and believe it in my heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead, that I shall be saved. And with the heart, man believes unto righteousness. Mm-hmm. And with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. And all that is saying that is, if you say, Lord, I'm a sinner, forgive me of my sins, cleanse me, Lord, from all unrighteousness, Lord, and come into my heart and life and save me. If you say that or something in those words, God has forgiven you. And He has done the most powerful thing in you already. He has come into your heart and your life and saved you. It's just that simple.
That's right.
It's not algebra. Mm-hmm. It's not rocket science. You just got to believe it.
That's right.
Believe God and take Him at His word, and He'll do what only He can do.
Yeah.
That save you just like He saved me.
Right.
So if you have accepted Jesus and you are wanting to know what's the next step, I ask that you put it in the comments. And that you let us know that you received salvation today. And we can connect you either to this church or a church of your choice. But you are in the family of God. And that's what Jesus died for. He died so you could live. Because He wants to live in you and through you.
Amen.
So that's my message for today. I like to pray for everyone that's on the line. Mm-hmm. And thank you for tuning in for us today. God is so good.
Yes, He is.
That His words can reach all boundaries. And Father God, I just thank You, Lord, for You being an awesome God. Lord, and that if there was anybody that was on the line that received Christ today, Father God, we thank You, Lord, that they gave their life to You, because You already gave Your life for them. And Father God, we ask, Lord, that You bless them in a mighty way. Lord, we ask that You bless the people that's in here today. And Lord, that You give us traveling grace and mercy to travel back home to where our next destination. Lord, bless us, Lord, and bless the ones that's on the line. And bless those, Lord, that will watch this on the replay. Lord, let Your word penetrate their heart and let them realize, Father God, how powerful Your word really is to us, and let us apply it to our life. And Father God, we just thank You, we praise You, and we acknowledge Your presence. Now unto Him who is able to keep us from falling keep us from falling. And Lord, we just thank You, Lord, that You will keep us in everything, Lord, that we've committed to You. And that You bless us in a mighty way, Lord. And to Him be the glory, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Lord. We thank You, we praise You, and we acknowledge Your presence, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray, Father God. Amen.
Amen.
Thank You for tuning in. Thank You for stopping by.
Amen.